because if you bring a new plant into your collection with an established plant, you don't know what the other one might be carrying potentially. So pathogens can be passed on. But good growers always have that control as well. Like I mentioned, flush the pot through, and when you water mounts, you'll notice that the roots turn from white to green. So roots are what is covered in velamen. Velamen is a spongy layer around the roots, which soaks up that moisture and transfers it to that tiny root fiber within the center of that. So this is my Cattleya walkeriana, cerulea form. And the green tips right here are the active roots. So those are always going to be green when they're actively growing. But the white part is the velamen. And I did repot that into something just slightly larger. We'll talk about that. With fertilizing your plants, I would say do a half strength, at least done weekly when they're actively growing. I prefer to use the Michigan State University orchid fertilizer. You can use Dyna-Grow, and in your pots, you can even use a nice slow-release granular fertilizer, whether that be Osmocote or Nutricote as well. Growers like to say weekly. It's something easy to remember to say, hey, fertilize once a week with a weak fertilizer solution. You don't want to overdo it. You don't want to burn your orchid roots. They're not the fastest growing plants. So if you set the roots back, you set the plant back. But overall, they are pretty forgiving. Flush the pot of excess salts just with a thorough watering to remove any buildup